Hallelujah! Christ is risen!
He is risen indeed! Hallelujah!
Yeah, it's still Easter. See, when Tiffany and I were first dating, she worked at Pentapena Lutheran in Fargo as a youth director, and I would attend church services with her. I'm kind of a church geek, so I would eagerly await the changing of the church seasons. Early on in our relationship, I was trying to impress her by showing off my extensive church knowledge. It was Easter as then as well, and I would attend every service wearing red, thinking that that Sunday was indeed Pentecost Sunday. However, I wore red for 3 or 4 weeks in a row, knowing in my head that those Sundays were the appropriate Sunday to wear red. You see, I was dying with well, it's that time of year again. Graduations are happening. The spring we thought we knew is fading fast. And most of Minnesota is looking forward to finally being able to go to that mystical land commonly known as up north, or otherwise known as heading to the lake. High school seniors are looking forward towards next year with eager giddiness, hoping that their first year out of high school is just as awesome as they hope it to be. However, most of them will be leaving home. Home where their friends and family are, where they feel, well, at home. Home is where their heart is. Home is where they rest their head at night. Home is home. Taking a chance at a new way of life is scary. With having very little to base what their life will be like in a little while, this impending change is exciting, but scary. Graduation is an achievement in itself, jumping through all the hoops that high school throws at us just to stand in front of all our friends, neighbors, teachers, fellow students, our family, to accept a degree that will propel us into our next phase of life. Change is exciting, but change is scary. But it's more than change that we're fearful of, it's the absence. That high school senior will be missed by their family and friends. Those friends and family members will look upon the empty room of the recently absented high school senior and wish they were still there. That high school senior will hopefully enjoy their new phase of life, but there will be moments where they miss the life they had back home. The absence of the familiar can be unsettling and lonesome, but life will eventually go on. We miss what we knew best. We knew who we knew best. Once upon a time, I was a graduating senior, fearful to leave home, so I didn't. Life was perfect at the time, so I didn't want to disturb that perfection. My dad was working here in the cities, my mom was living in California, and I stayed in Morris. That first summer after high school, I went out to work at Luthercrest Bible Camp up in Alexandria, and then came back and didn't go to college. I had my reasons, but none of them were the right reasons. But I was on my own, and I could make my own decisions if I pleased. I worked for 2 months at the Town and Country Hardware Store, one of three in Morris, right next to each other. Seriously, three hardware stores in two blocks, right next to each other. It's a small town. And then at McDonald's for the rest of that school year. I didn't go to college right away, and it wasn't the usual absence that I feared or faced. You see, I already missed the absence of my family, for they were already gone elsewhere before I even graduated high school. I didn't miss my friends because the one high school friend worth keeping in touch with was also abstaining from college that year, and we hung out all the time.